So this is a new topic and it is called as mass fault diagram. It is related to volumes, the topic that we had taken in the previous lecture. Consider a ground which is there, and this is what you're seeing is the change, and this is the original profile of the ground. And let us say that we want to build a road. Now this ground, you see this ground is not straight, or it is not in a level, it is undulated, and obviously the road that we are building should not be undulated, it should be a leveled road, right? So I need this proposed road like this. So obviously this part I'll have to cut, this part I'll have to fill, again this part I'll have to cut, right? And this part I'll have to fill, obviously. So to do this, let us first tabulate everything. We have our chainage, what we call a station, then we have cut. So from 0 to 2, that is from 0 to 2, how much volume of the soil needs to be cut is 21.4 cubic meter of soil has to be cut. That is still 16 and 8, yeah, somewhere in between, right? After that we have fill. So this soil has to be this depth or this excavation which is there, that has to be filled, right? Then here again there is a cut, and then there is a fill. Now we have to consider shrinkage. Why we have to consider shrinkage? Because when you cut this soil, or basically when we need to fill this portion, right? We need to fill this excavation with some soil. So let us say that you get some soil from a borrow pit. I guess you might have solved these numericals in geotechnical, the borrow pit numericals. We borrow the soil and then we dump it somewhere, right? So the soil which is borrowed, it will have some void ratio, let's say E1. When we are dumping it here, the soil gets compacted. The soil is compacted. Naturally, if the soil is compacted, its void ratio will be less than E1. Correct? The void ratio of this soil which is compacted will be lesser than the soil from where we are borrowing it, or lesser than the undisturbed soil, basically. Okay. What does this mean? What does this void ratio mean? Void ratio is what? Volume of voids upon volume of solids, right? Volume of voids by volume of solids, correct? So less void ratio means what? Void ratio is directly proportional to volume of voids. It means lesser the void ratio, lesser the volume of voids, and total volume is equal to volume of solids plus volume of voids. So if void ratio is decreasing, your volume of voids are decreasing, it means the total volume is also decreasing in the second case when we are dumping it. So the volume, since the volume is decreasing, what is that decrease called? It is called a shrinkage, right? So basically when you are dumping your soil in some pit to fill it up, basically you are compacting that soil in that pit, and when you are compacting, you are decreasing the void ratio. Since you are decreasing the void ratio, the volume of the entire soil is reducing. Since it is reducing, we have to consider this shrinkage. So this shrinkage, now you might have known, you might have understood that this shrinkage is only to be considered when we are filling the soil. So equivalent fill, this one more column has to be added here, and you will have to calculate the equivalent filling, how much filling you will have to require, so that at the end you get 16.15 cubic meter. So that is a very simple calculation. Let us say X is the volume of soil that we need to borrow to fill in this pit. So X minus 14.3% of X should give you 16.15. So you are borrowing your soil X cubic meter, then you are subtracting how much shrinkage is going to happen, 14.13% of X. At the end, the final volume you should get is this volume, because this is required, right? So when you solve this, you get somewhere around 18.84, something like that. So we need to calculate this only for the fill part, not for the cut part, only for the fill part we need to calculate these values. And then we need to write the cumulative. So this 0, 21.4, 21.4 plus 68.55 here, then this plus this, like that we need to keep on writing. Then when we come to fill, we have to subtract it. So 802.34 minus fill, then 783.5 minus 45.65, like this. Again, when we come to cut, we need to keep on adding it. Again, when we come to fill, it is not this one, it is this equivalent. So 802.34 minus 18.84, then 783.5 minus 53.27, and so on and so forth. Then when you reach here, you will have to add the cut, again you will have to subtract the fill, and finally you get to this point till your last change, 60. Now we have one more set of data with us, that is we have station and we have this cumulative mass, right? Let us see what happens if we plot that. So when you plot that, you get something, a curve like this. This is nothing but this is called as your mass foil diagram. This cumulative mass curve that you have drawn is called as mass foil diagram. What is the significance of this mass foil diagram? You see, you start from this point 0, then again it cuts somewhere at 0. Wherever it is cutting, at whichever change it is cutting, that is called as a balance point. So it is the point where mass foil diagram intersects the baseline, and at this point the volume of cut is equal to volume of fill. What does that mean? These are called as balance points, where your mass foil diagram is cutting the baseline. Baseline is this chain edge. Okay, what is this? What, there was one more statement attached with it, that volume of cut is equal to volume of fill at this point. So why it is happening? See, you are adding your cut, right? 0 plus 21.4 plus 68.5, right, till you reach some point. Then you are subtracting it till it reaches 0 again, right? So how the amount of cut that you had added, same amount of fill you are subtracting when you reach 0. So the amount of cut that you added till this point, same amount of fill you are subtracting to reach 0. What does that mean? That at this point, just a minute, at this point the amount of cut that you are going to do of your original profile, this same amount can be filled here. The same amount of soil can be used to fill till this portion. Okay, till this portion. Then again we have another balance point. So this much amount of fill. Now one more characteristic of this mass foil curve is that a rising limb represents a cut and a falling limb represents a fill. So a falling limb here till this point, then again there is a cut till this point, till this change. So whatever amount of cut that you are doing till this change, this same amount can be filled in this part. Okay, again there is a balance point here. So till this much part it is filling, till this much part it is cut, and then again it is filling. So whatever you are cutting, this you can fill here. And then there is some surplus amount of fill which is required, that we can borrow from somewhere else. So you understood the importance of this mass foil diagram. There are other importance as well. Second is called as haul. The transportation of excavated material from its original position to its final location in the work or other disposal area. This it is called as hall, and this is also known as authorized hall. So hall or authorized hall. Okay. So it is nothing but the distance from, let's say you have cut this much part. So from this much part, which is the easiest or which is the nearest location where you can fill it? Obviously this, right? So this should be filled here, a hall distance. Then again, this much part you can fill somewhere here. So basically from where you are cutting till the point you are filling, that distance is called as hall distance. Okay, like this. So obviously each successive hall distance will keep on increasing. Next is called as average hall or free hall. Average hall is the area of the mass diagram between the balance points divided by maximum ordinate of the curve between the balance points. So average hall is like, it is the area of the mass diagram between the balance point. This is one of the balance point, this is another balance point, divided by the maximum ordinate of that mass hall diagram. So what you are actually doing is that you are taking the average of this mass. Basically, like if I try to divide it, let's say this distance, then let's say this distance, like this. Just bear with me and understand what is happening. Let's say I want to take average of all these distances. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll add all them up and I'll divide it obviously by 7. But let's say if I need to take average of all the closely, very, very close lines that I'll be joining all together. So if I add them up, by what amount should I divide it? It is obviously this value, this entire value, right, till this point, because that is the y ordinate or that is the y coordinate of this diagram, mass flow diagram. So all these, when you, and basically when you keep on adding all these lines, what you are essentially doing is that you are finding the mass, you are finding the area of this mass curve. And then you are dividing it by this value or this ordinate, maximum ordinate. So what you get finally is called as average hall. Or you will get one distance which is called as average hall. That's it. Now, diagrammatically, if I have to show you what average hall is, that this cut will go here. As I told you, the cut is going to success. This hall is going to keep on increasing. So average of all these halls is called as average hall. Nothing more. Average of all these halls is called as average hall. Overhaul. The hauling in excess of free hall distance beyond the balance point is called as overhaul. So this distance, this is called as overhaul, because after this point you need some extra efforts to fill this point, right? Uses of mass hall diagram. First, let us see this. Which different equipments are used? Dozers, scrapers and trucks. All these different kind of equipments, they have their economic hauls already set. The economic haul of a dozer is around 90 meters. So if you employ this dozer, just a minute. If you employ this dozer to work for around where the average haul is around 90 meters, then this dozer would be beneficial or it would be advantageous to use. But if the average haul is lying in this range, 90 meters to 1500 meters, then it is more suitable to use scrapers. And if it is lying above 1500 meters, then trucks are more suitable to use. Now this everything is including the cost of these equipments, then the petrol requirement or the diesel requirement of each and every equipment, then how much they can carry, how much load they can carry, and for how much meters. So including all those factors, we come to this economic haul. Now how does the mass haul diagram help us? Let us say this is the mass haul diagram, right? Let us say that trucks lie in this range. Their economic haul is 1500. So let us say that trucks are here somewhere, scrapers are a little bit above, and dozers are here according to their economic haul. And mind you that this x coordinate on this graph is distance. So we are not equating apples with oranges, we are equating apples with apples, right? We are equating distance to distance. In this graph we are showing distance. Okay. Yeah. So based on the so what you can do is that, let us say that you are cutting this point, cutting this and filling it here. If the distance from this point to this point is around 90 meters, then you can employ dozers to work only in this zone, right? You can allow dozers to work only in this zone. So the dozer won't go beyond this zone to get the fill and to get the cut and to get it back to the fill. Let us say that the cut from this part, when you have to dump it in this part, if the distance between that is around 90 to 1500, you can employ scrapers from this part to this part, and beyond this part you can employ the trucks. So you can use all these three equipments together, but defining their zones, that till which point to which point dozer has to work, till which point to which point scraper has to work, and similarly the truck has to work. So this can be done from mass haul diagram. So using mass haul diagram, the project manager can determine which equipment will be economical for the hauling purpose. The project manager can also determine if a single equipment is sufficient or combination of equipments would be beneficial. As I told you, that you can use combination of dozer, scraper, truck, and there are other equipments also. These are just few that I have listed here. There are many other equipments. With mass diagram, it can be determined how much overhauling is required, and how to minimize it, and how to make the project cost optimal. Mass haul diagram is used to identify borrow pits and dumping sites, that is where you are cutting and where you are filling. Borrow pits are your cutting, and dumping sites is filling. Mass haul diagram is used to identify distance till which there is no additional requirement of borrow fill material. Helps to plan movement of excavated soil of work site from cuts to fill, so that haul distance be minimum to reduce the cost of work. And this was it, right? If you have any doubts in this, feel free to ask me. And in the next lecture, we'll be doing the advanced thing. Till then, take care.